So again, if I don't know you personally, my name is Lacey Covanda. I'm a Revelation Wellness instructor in the Kansas City area, Overland Park to be exact. And typically we'd be at the park on Wednesday mornings, but we get to work out here because God sent us rain this morning, which we desperately needed. So we will be back at the park on Friday. If you live in the area and you want to know what park we work out at, you can private message me and I will get you the address because we would love for you to join us. While I'm moving, go ahead and start warming up if you want. March in place, do some shoulder circles. Anywhere you kind of feel where you need to loosen up, do some dynamic moves, which just means move rather than hold a static stretch. All right, get that blood flowing. But we are in Proverbs 4:23-27 today. And it says, above all else, guard your heart, for it is the wellspring of life. Put away perversity from your mouth. Keep corrupt talk far from your lips or far from your social media posts, whatever you, however you express what's in your heart. Let your eyes look straight ahead. Lift your gaze or fix your gaze directly before you. Make level the paths for your feet and take only ways that are firm. Do not swerve to the right or to the left. Keep your foot from evil. And as I was reading this, it just, God reminded me, like, who or what am I seeking? Above all else, guard your heart, for it is the wellspring of life, right? And there are many things that can have, that have opinions. We have our own opinions, right? And so we have to make a conscious choice of what am I listening to? What am I reading? What am I giving my attention to? Because that affects how I live, right? So there's many voices, there's many things coming at us, but we have to filter them all through God's word and through his love, right? And are we seeking the Lord above all else, or are we seeking other things? Yeah, so let's move in that. We'll kind of work that out, let God work that out in our hearts while we move. Above all else, guard your heart, for it is the wellspring of life. It talks about keeping your feet on firm ground, and we know that's the solid foundation of God's truth. And we will fix our gaze above, and we won't get distracted to the right or to the left. Now, I know we make mistakes, but God's going to draw us back, and we're going to commit to him again. All right? Okay. Good morning. Yay! Hi, Susan. Good to see you. Hi, Anne. All right, let's go ahead and get started with some warm-up songs here. All right. This song isn't any necessary choreography or anything. We're just going to start by marching in place, standing up nice and tall, opening the chest, opening the heart. Good. Engaging that belly button. Pump those arms as big as you want. Good. Maybe turn the corners of your mouth up. Good job. We're going to take it to a step touch. So you're just going to tap your heels or your toes. Kind of pull those shoulders in front and then on the back. And then reach up high. If you want to add the hamstring curl, go for it. Good. Above all else, guard your heart, for it's the wellspring of life. Good job. Keep it here. You got it. Let's switch it up, and we're going to do some front kicks. So you kind of pick the knee up, kick the heel out, stretching the back of that leg. It doesn't have to be high. Good. Keep it here. We're going to switch to just high knees with a twist. Opposite elbow to the opposite knee. You don't have to touch the two. Just keep that back nice and straight. All right, let's roll our shoulders out. So kind of a wide leg stance here. And just roll that shoulder out. Switch sides. Good. Take those deep breaths. Now just reach side to side. Get as long as you can in your back. Good, and then overhead. Good job. All right, step one foot forward, reach up high, pull back in those hips, stretch the backs of those legs. Good job. Other side. Reach out. Pull back to those hips. You got it. One more. And we're going to stretch our back. Hands on the inside of your thighs. Inhale as we drop your belly. Look up. Exhale. Round it out. Good job. Inhale up. Exhale. One more. Good job. And then just kind of look over one shoulder. Switch. Go the other way. Wide leg stance here. Just kind of reach. Step back in those hips. Reach toward that opposite toe. Good job. All right. Go ahead and grab your sticks. Go ahead and grab your sticks. First drumstick song is called Good Feeling. It's not about getting all the moves right. It's just about moving and having fun. All right, you're gonna point to the side. Ready? Here we go. Point, hit in the front. Keep going. Switch sides. I needed some more volume. You're gonna hit down and then up. Good. Keep going. As big as you want it. We're gonna move side to side. So it's one, two, three. You ready? One, two, three. All right, point again. Bring those shoulders on your back. Other side. How you feeling? Good job. All right, you hit down with the other arm first. Ready? Down, up. Good job. If you want more, you can hit under. We're going back to side. You can step touch if you want. Side to side. Just have fun. Bring it forward. Ready? Backwards. Bring the knee up. Come to the side. Other way. Good job again. Nice controlled movement. Again. Other side. Last time. All right. Figure it down. And then slowly work your way on up. You're going to hit down. And then other side. Or then you're going to kick. Ready? Here we go. Switch sides. Keep going. Side to side. Ready? Oh, it's fun to move together. I wish we were in person. We'll get there, don't worry. Forward. Backwards. Big finish. Woo! Good job. Alright, here's an oldie but a goodie. Oh, now I have a ton of volume. Let me turn it down. Alright, you're going to hold your sticks together. Then you're going to pull them up. And then twist, other side. As low as you want to go with your legs. Drive that elbow behind. Good job. You're going to hit down for two. And then overhead. Other side. Good job. These are called wood choppers. Keep going. Run it out, and you can hit forward and back. Good job. Big circles. Ready? Got our eye on it. We're going to fix our eyes on the Lord. Switch. He's going to keep us on solid ground. Switch. All right, hold them together. Pull it up. Elbow back. Good. As you take that elbow back, hip goes forward. Feel that core engage. All right, hit two down and then overhead. Reach. Good job. As we fix our gaze on the Lord, He keeps us firm in His truth. Run it out. Because there's so many voices we could be listening to, getting us off course, big circles. Switch. Are we seeking the Lord more, first and foremost? Are we seeing what's on social media or on the news? Oh, twist. Where are we fixing our gaze, setting our heart upon? Good job. Keep those elbows high. Alternate forward and backwards. It's called around the world. Good job. If you don't hit the ground, it's good. You got it. Ready? You're going to switch. So go forward with the other arm first. Feel those legs. Keep going. All right. Hold it together. Twist. If you need to take a break, you just come on up in your legs. You're doing so good. Down. And then back. Woohoo! High stick. How you guys doing? Yay, so good to see you guys. I'm glad you got it. So we're here today, back at the park on Friday. All right. Keep it low. So center, out. Again, you adjust what your legs and your knees need. Hold it wide, too, on each side. Now single. Good. Big circles. Switch again. Last time. We're going two times to each foot. Ready? Just sway back and forth. Hit down and bring it up for three. Good job. Two times each set. Mid like we have no what ifs. Center. Bring it up. Good job. All right, back to the top, ready? Here we go, center, out. Good. Set back in those hips. All the weight's in our heels. Big circles. Give those legs a break. Switch. Switch again. Last circle. All right. Sway back and forth. Here we go. Drive those elbows up. Just have fun. Hit center. Two times each set. Can you still smile? Hit center. We're going to kick forward and then sideways. Switch. Pull those shoulders on your back. Quicker. Finish strong. Center. circle. Hip down. Finish it here. Born Again by Austin French. You hear the drum roll? Do you just drum roll up? Hold your stick together. One lunge each side. You're gonna hit center, stand together. Other way. Keep it this side. Reverse lunge. Two more. Keep it wide. Other side for four. Back to the drum roll. If you want more, you do you. Hold them together. One lunge each side. Hit center, step together. Oh, it's good to move together. All in God's love. Reverse lunge for four. Keep it wide, other side. Four. Knee. Side. We're doing this a lot today. Crunch that side body. Control movement. Good job. Pull those shoulders on your back. One more. Hit center. Step. You've been saved. We're born again. Reverse lunge for four. Keep it wide, other side for four. Drum roll. Finish it here. Again, you don't have to hop together. Keep going. Good. One more song. Then we're going to drink and switch it up. Good job. All right. Sunk a lot of legs. You can do it. Come on down. Open the chest up. I'm going to go two times to that one heel. Pause in the center. Two times. Pause. Other way. Always takes me a minute to find the beat. Can you smile? Go ahead to the side. Other side. One more. Switch. You're going to drum roll across. Bring the knee up. Other way. Or you step touch. This is good too. You do you. Keep going. Open that chest up so your shoulders are on your back. I know it's long. You're doing so good. Little break. Little break. Back to the top. When you're ready, you come on down. And you open that chest. Two times. Pause in the center. Two. Pause. heel. Good job. Lunge to the side, overhead. Woo! Quick circles, ready? Quick. One more, switch. All the drum roll, ready? Bring the knee up, or step together. You don't have to hit the ground. Just keep moving in whatever feels like worship to you today. Worship to the Lord with all your heart, your mind, your soul, and your strength. Keep going. Woo. We're doing it together, even if we're in our own homes. Come on back. Come on down. Open the chest again. Two times each side. Two. Pause. You can do it. Come on. Drum roll. Ready? Hold it. Here we go. I missed it. This is good. You can step. You do you. Thanks for moving with me today. I see you guys there. Big circles. Actually, no, we're done. We're done. Good job. How you feeling? High five. Good work. Elbow bump. Grab a drink. All right. You're done with the sticks. Grab a drink. Grab a lighter set of weights. Soup cans work great. Or something you can use like weights. If you don't want to grab weights, that's okay too. But I need a drink. I know that. Good. Your weight, find a space to move, a lighter set of weights. We're going to move at your own pace for 30 seconds. Roll those shoulders back and down, follow me here, raise them straight up, go out like a T, and then down. Come up like a T in front, and down. So go at whatever pace you can. Slight bend on those elbows. Draw those shoulders on your back. You have 10 more seconds here. Embrace the sweat. It's just rolling now that we stopped. 3, 2, 1, rest. Rest. 15 seconds rest. Our next move is we're gonna hold a high row. Extend one out. Extend the other out and then down. 30 seconds. Ready? Set. Begin. Hold the high row. Extend. Extend. Down. Good. It feels awkward. It's not a move we typically do, but it's good. When you bring those weights up, bring those shoulders on your back because our chest wants to come together. Open up the chest. You have 7 more seconds. 2, 1, rest. All right. Next move. Our arms are out like goalposts, so we're going to press it up, come back down, crunch together, out, up. Still rest. 30 seconds. Ready? Begin. So press, come here, crunch together, out, up. Try to keep those elbows as high as your shoulders are. Okay? Open that chest. Oh, they might be shaking. You're doing good. Aren't you glad you grabbed a lighter set of weights? Yes. 8 seconds. Keep working. It's okay if you're moving slower than me, quicker than me. Rest. Rest. Set them down. We're going to shake those arms out. We're going to do that all again. 30 seconds each move. All right? Adjust your weights if you need. Or no weights. I promise you, it's still a good move. Move with intention. You don't even have to have weights. Just focus on those muscles contracting. All right? All right. Back to the T arms in 5 seconds. Roll those shoulders back and out. Open the chest. Begin. Up, out, down. Out, forward, down. Good. Engage that belly button toward the back. Open that chest. Halfway. It's okay if this 30 seconds feels harder. Because we've already done this move, so our muscles are tired. It's okay. 5 seconds. Good form. And rest. Muscle discomfort is different than joint pain, all right? No joint pain. You take a break or you modify how high you go or whatever you need to honor your body. Ready? High row. Extend the triceps. Keeping that elbow as still as you can. I get it, this feels super awkward. It's good though. Keep those elbows high. Even if you don't extend all the way, what can you do? 10 seconds. How are those shoulders? They're screaming at us, yeah? 2, 1, rest. All right, shoulder press with the chest crunch. Still rest, you have 10 more seconds to rest. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Press, bring them together. Again, elbows are high. We got lots of shoulders today. You're doing good. There's halfway. Engage that core, no pain on your back. If you have any pain on your back, I want you to drop your weight. And if that still bothers your back, just cheer somebody on. 2, 1, rest. You're not disqualified. All right. Rest. Shake those arms out. One last round. All right. One last round. If you're like, I am done, that's fine. It's fine. Just encourage somebody else. Aw, thank you, Erica. You encourage me. So good. It's so good to be here together. All right. Last round. Last round. We're going to start in 5 seconds. T arms, okay? Ready? Begin. Up, out, down. As you think about your day, what do you search for? Who are you searching out? If it's anything or anyone other than the Lord, can I challenge us, when we're tempted to go to social media or to the news, can we open up His Word and read a few verses? Maybe you start with Psalms. Rest. Maybe you start with the book of John. Can it just be open on your counter somewhere so that it's there? Or maybe you don't close your Bible app on your phone. High row with the tricep extension. Go. Oops, other side. I almost forgot to do both sides. So I'll share with you some things that I'm terrible about being on social media way too much, and God has been convicting me of it. And so I've asked Him for His help, and He said, you know, when sometimes when you want to like lose weight or whatever, everybody tracks their food. Like, you track your food so you know what you're putting in or how much energy you're expending. So you track all that. Rest. He said, I want you to write down what time you jumped on Facebook and then what time you got off. Same with Instagram. And by me having to put it down, write it down. All right, shoulder press, go. Shoulder press, chest crunch. I don't know what to call this move. Anyways, by me having to physically write down that time has totally checked me. Like, it has been a good tool. It's like, what am I putting in my mind, right? Like we write down our food for the calories we eat. I used to, I don't anymore. 5 more seconds. And so by having to do that, I really had to like see it, physically see it, be like, nope, I'm good. Rest. Rest. I wasn't planning on talking about all this today, but it's good. I think maybe somebody else needs to hear it as well. So I have this note card, and I just have like Facebook, a column for Facebook, and a column for Instagram. I get on Facebook at 12:05, and then I jump off at 12:30, and I'm like, man, that was 25 minutes, right? And now there's grace, right? Maybe we're posting about pictures, or maybe we're on social media to encourage other people that we see on there. That's good too, but for me, I need this like tracking to help me become aware of where my thoughts have been going, how much time I've been consuming there, versus how much am I seeking the Lord and His Word. Anyways, maybe that can encourage you or help you. So I know I definitely need it, and I'm still in process. Like, I'm on day 5 of this, so I'm still working on it. All right. Grab your mat or find a spot on the ground. We have 2 moves before we stretch it out. You don't need any weight. We're still going to go with our 30 seconds, but our first move, we're going to come onto our hands and our knees, and we do bird dogs, where it's opposite hand and opposite foot, and we alternate. This time, we're going to focus just on one side, and we're going to crunch, and we're going to extend for 30 seconds, all right? You still get time to rest, and then after 30 seconds, we're going to do the other side. Ready? Pick your side, belly button tucked in. Begin, out and in. When you crunch in, your back can arch slightly. When you go out, make sure it's flat. It doesn't cave, all right? Exhale, 12 seconds. And then you're going right into the other side in 5, 2, 1, switch. You might find it's easier to do one side than the other. It's okay, sorry for my breathing. Maybe it encourages you to keep breathing. Again, flat back, slight arch. 8 seconds. Then you're getting a rest. 2, 1, rest. Rest, step back into child's pose for a second. Stretch that back out. Next move, if you need some padding, you can roll up your mat. We're gonna be in a plank position on your knees or on your toes, and you're gonna rock side to side, all right? Your hips don't have to touch the ground. You're just gonna rock side to side, shoulders out of your ears, open that chest, ready? Set, begin, side to side. Look up, don't do like me. Look up, don't drop that head. You can be on your knees. You can be on your knees and swaying your hips. It's good, you're halfway. Child's pose. One more round of it, just one more. Back to the bird dogs. Can you start on the weaker side? Try to start on your weaker side. Ready? Begin. Last 30 seconds. This side, then we're going right into 30 seconds of the other. Taking a 15 second rest into rocking planks, and then you're done. 15 more seconds. Seven, push through that back heel. Switch, out, in. You're doing so good. Above all else, guard your heart, for it is the wellspring of life. how we guard our heart is in the Lord alone. 7 seconds. 2, 1, rest. 15 second rest. The last 30 seconds will work. Good job. All right, come into your plank position. Ready? Last 30 seconds. Go. Side to side. This bothers your back or your shoulders, your hips. Just hold the plank. Hold the plank. There's halfway. Good. Can you turn the corners of your mouth up? 7 seconds. 2, 1. Rest. Rest. Settle back into child's pose again. Take those deep breaths in and out. No rush here. Rest as long as you want here. Keep resting, but when you're ready, you slowly come on up. You can grab your water bottle. We're going to stretch it out. And it's just the sweat is pouring out today. Woo! Good. You're in good company. Get comfortable whether your shoes are on or off. You did such a good job today. Whatever position is comfortable to you. Maybe you like to sit crisscross. Maybe you want to be on your knees. Let me just check, see how you guys are doing. Okay, good? Okay. All right. When you're ready, come onto your knees or your bottom. Go ahead and take those deep breaths in as you reach up high. And then when you exhale, you're going to bring it down. Good. Just keep following your breath. Inhale up. Exhale, bring it on down. One more time up. As you exhale, go ahead and bring those hands back behind you. Grab them on your back. Open that chest. Look up. Good. When you're ready, you're going to release that one hand straight down on the mat. The other one straight up. Get as long as you can. Inhale. Exhale as you twist it across, slide it across. Inhale to the top, straight up. Bring that hand straight down. Inhale, reach straight up. Get long. Exhale to the side. Inhale to the top, straight up. Exhale down. Take those arms wide. Give yourself a great big hug. Grab those shoulders. Pull them apart. Exhale as you roll forward. Stretch out those shoulders. When you're ready, slowly roll yourself all the way up. Let your head be the last thing that comes up. Inhale as you take your arms wide. Exhale, bring the other arm on top. Grab those shoulders, roll it forward. Tuck your chin. Feel that blood just flow into your head. Inhale as you sit yourself up. Let your head be the last thing that comes up. Good. Take your arms wide again. Bring one across. Pull that arm in. Draw that shoulder back. Look the opposite way. When you're ready, you can inhale, reach up high. Exhale, pull it behind you. Use your head to help stretch that tricep. Release that when you're ready. Arms wide. Exhale to bring the other arm across. Draw the shoulder back. Exhale to the opposite way of your hand. Inhale, reach up high. Exhale, bring the hand behind you. Again, use that head. Release that when you're ready. We're going to come onto our hands and our knees. Start stretching our back. Inhale, look up. When you're ready, exhale, round it out. Following your breath, inhale, looking up, and exhale, round it out. Neutral position. If you can tuck your toes under, tuck your toes under. Exhale, push your hips high into that downward dog. It's like you're stretching the mat away from itself. Drop those shoulders out of your ears. Walk your feet right and left using your breath. Good. Inhale, as you come into a plank position, drop those knees down, then just lower your upper body down to the mat. Rest your forehead on the mat. Inhale, as you take your upper body away from the mat. Exhale down. Inhale, as you push yourself back into child's pose. Rest that forehead on the mat. As you take deep breaths in and out, just release the tension that you feel in your neck. Maybe you start with your face. Breathe into your forehead. Soften your jaw. And then work on down your neck. It's almost as if your head gets heavier because your neck releases the tension, so you can just rest fully in the mat. Good. Inhale as you lift yourself up and walk your hands toward one side of the mat. Exhale on down. Pause as long as you want on one side, and when you're ready, you're going to inhale and walk your hand to the other side. Exhale into that. When you're ready, inhale back to center. Exhale into child's pose. All fours, tuck those toes under. Exhale, as you push yourself up into downward dog again. Drop those shoulders out of your ears. Inhale into plank position. Drop those knees down, switch your feet. Lift that chest. Inhale, as you push yourself back into all fours. Bring one leg in front into a runner's lunge. Deep breath in and out. Inhale as you push yourself back. Straighten this front leg. Be kind with your body. Feel the stretch on the bottom of this leg. Inhale, come forward. Both hands on the inside of that front leg. Your knee can come really far forward. Release that when you're ready. Push yourself up. This front leg, go ahead and wiggle it across. set that knee on the mat. Exhale as you sink down into your hips and stretching forward. You can walk your hands to one side. Exhale. And then switch and go the other side. Being kind and gentle with your body, even in stretching. Use your breath. Coming back to center when you're ready, you're going to push your upper body up, stretching the front of that back leg. Exhale, come down. Inhale, as you take that knee back, switch our legs, other leg in front. Your hands on each side of that foot. Deep breath in and out. Inhale as you step back. Exhale as you fold over this front leg. Good. When you're ready, inhale, coming forward, both hands on the inside of that front knee. Exhale down into it. Press yourself up slightly, wiggle that front foot across. Set that knee down on the mat. Exhale as you fold forward. You're gonna inhale, take your hands to one side. Exhale. Ready, you're going to inhale, walk them all the way to the other side. Exhale when you get there. And then coming back to center, pause for a second. Inhale as you push yourself up. Exhale at the top, stretching the front of the back leg. Release that. Inhale as you push yourself back. We're going to come onto our back for the last little bit. When you get there, go ahead and hug both knees into your chest. As you hug those knees in, exhale as you sink those shoulders down to the mat. One hand on each knee and just rock side to side. My back just popped, felt good. As we breathe, stretch, helps loosen up our joints. Go ahead and take your knees into a big circle. Using your breath, moving at the pace you want, as big a circle as you want. Feel those hips and that lower back release the tension that they often hold. When you're ready, you're going to switch and go the other side. It's okay if you're accidentally rolling onto a side. It's all good. Just play with whatever movement and stretching that you need for your body. It may be different than what I'm doing, and that's good. You follow what you need. Coming back to center, exhale, release one leg straight. You're gonna flex your feet, point them, and then just roll your ankles into a circle. And then switch the other way. Deep breath in as you hug that knee tight. Exhale, across. Open that chest, look the opposite way. Inhale, coming onto your back, both knees in. Exhale, release the other leg straight. Flex your feet, roll those ankles. Switch other way. Separating your toes as big as you can. Just wiggle your toes. breath in, and then exhale as you twist across. Gaze the opposite way. Your back. One last tug of the knees and then just let your feet come out and just let your ankles fall to the side, or if you want to stretch in a different position, feel free to do that. Keep stretching, keep resting. Deep breath in and out. Proverbs 4:23-27, above all else, guard your heart, for it is the wellspring of life. Put away perversity from your mouth. Keep corrupt talk far from your lips. Let your eyes look straight ahead. Fix your gaze directly before you. Make level paths for your feet and take only ways that are firm. Do not swerve to the right or the left. Keep your foot from evil. So there's many voices that are speaking, right? And there's so much noise to get us distracted, right? And they're not getting any quieter. But God's word is true. It's everlasting. It's going to be here forever. So who or what are you seeking today? May we seek the Lord above all else, for he is always worthy of all praise and worship. And only God is the keeper and sustainer of all truth. And it is God alone who can guard our hearts and minds. So may we look straight ahead to him, because he makes our paths level and sure, like stable. He keeps us in alignment with him and with his ways when we're tempted to veer to the right or to the left. May we desire him and his truth above anything else. And he's so faithful to keep us in step with him. Whenever we find ourselves out of alignment, it's not because God moved, it's because we did. And yet he draws us back. And he sets us firmly in his truth again. And I don't know about you, but I am quick to forget. And so I need to remember. I need his word, to read his word, to soak in his word, in his truth. And as I do that, it's his truth in me that he will bring about the things that he wants to in me and through me. He guards our hearts. I don't know about you, but I need my heart to be guarded at all times, especially with all this media and noise around us. We need a guarder of our heart, and that is God. So before we're tempted to believe something we hear or say or read about, can we first filter it through the truth of God's word? As we go to him and his truth, may his truth flow out of us into the conversations we have, into the social posts, social media posts we make, and just how we live our lives for him. Father God, we thank you so much that you are steady and you are true. We praise you for being immovable. You're immortal. You're our eternal God, only wise God, the Lord of all creation. We praise you and thank you for guarding our hearts in your truth and your ways. Lord, help us to fix our minds and our hearts on you, that we would be in alignment with you, that our hearts would be guarded in you, and as they're guarded in you, we would be your instruments of praise and thanksgiving and truth and goodness here on the earth. Thank you for your patience with us. Thank you for bringing us back in alignment with you. We ask for your strength and for your spirit to keep us from veering to the right or to the left. May you be our heart's greatest desire. We thank you for never giving up on us, but continuing your good work in us. God, we just open our hearts and our minds and our lives up to you, and we just ask that your will would be done in us and through us. And we know that as we're fixed on you, as we seek you above all else, you will direct our paths. You will guide our words. You will lead us into the assignments that you have for us today. So God, we offer ourselves to you. And we just say thank you. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your great love for us. You're so incredibly good to us. May we bring you the praise and the thanksgiving that you so deserve. So God, we just say, here we are, have all of us for all of you. Thank you so much for this time to move. We thank you for the good gift of these bodies. Lord, these bodies are instruments of your praise and your worship. We don't worship them. We just get to use them to go into the things that you have us for today. Help us to be faithful in mind, in body, and in spirit. Thank you so much, Jesus, for your forgiveness, for washing us clean by your blood. Thank you for making us yours. We love you, Jesus. It's in your name that we pray. Amen. Great job today. I'm so proud of you. Thank you for joining.